initial times till now, do you think that things in India have changed? So if they have, what brought us to the change we are in? And how do you see this development process of great individuals, how do you see that being manifested in the modern times?
If I may add, how can these ideas, it's something that I'm assuming that they're not so relevant in today's systems. I'm assuming that these ideas of individual development, focusing on individual, are not so relevant in today's system.
No, we've gotten into mass production of everything.
So how can we actually bring it back, and how should India then, if I ask the question, how should India's model of development, is it to stay in the West or can we bring back the individual development?
See, for anything to happen, you need a certain ecosystem, certain economic, a certain economic depth for people to able to do it. You must understand this. The generation that we were growing up, our parents were just crazy that you must somehow get one degree and get into a government job. Your parents are not doing that. They're thinking little more easy. They're trying to explore things. They want you to do a startup, they want you to do a business, they want you to get into sport. This was never there. They were just saying, get a job somehow, otherwise you'll be on the street. This was the level of economics of the time. Today there is a little more economic space where parents are looking at their children little differently. Still we are little compressed in the heads, but little more ease than what it was 40-50 years ago. Ask all your professors. They were just push, get a job, first thing. Today, parents are not looking like that. They're looking at what can you create, what can our children create, what can they live, how about their happiness. Nobody ever thought about our happiness. Okay? So, it needs a certain economic depth for any society to experiment, to have little more freedom to do things. Otherwise, putting them through the extruder and getting them out in some form in which they are useful, this is what the society will do. This is a natural consequence of 15-20 generations of extreme poverty. This mental structure and this economic structure is a consequence of 15-20 generations of extreme poverty. Very bad poverty means India has suffered poverty like nobody else. People may show pictures of Africa and stuff, you must know this. In Africa, there have been famines, there have been wars, unnecessary wars and tribal wars which have caused this in small scale. In India, the level of malnourishment and poverty that's happened in the last 2 centuries is most painful. No other nation on the planet has suffered as much as this country. No other country has lost as many people as we have lost in the last century just for hunger and lack of nourishment. Even today it is true, though we are much better today, even today unfortunately it is true that we have the highest number of malnourished people in the country. More than 60% of the rural population, even today, they have not grown, their skeletal system has not grown to full size. When they're in that state, you're only thinking how to make a living. You're not thinking of how to open up human genius. You're not interested in all that. You're not thinking how to become self-realized. You're only thinking how to make a living. So this has happened to us because we've been an occupied nation for too long. We've been ripped off in every other way. There's no point blaming somebody. We didn't take care of it at that time. It went out of our hands. But 250, 300 years ago, everybody wanted to come to India. Why? Because it was the richest country on the planet. We occupied a 33% space in the economic space of the planet at one time. Today probably we are 2 or 3%. So, because of this extreme poverty, we have a certain mindset. But I think in a generation or in next 15-20 years, a whole lot of people will come out of this because there's little more ease, little more space to play with, little more space to push it. When an earthworm with 1/1,000,000th of your brain can earn a living. With such a big brain, earning a living, is it such a big problem? It is the most… it's the grossest way to approach life is, how will I earn my living? Everybody can earn their living. The only problem comes in your life when you want to live like somebody else. That's a problem. But earning a living is not a problem. If you just make what is considered survival minimal, don't go on exaggerating it, then you will see you have a whole lot of time and opportunity to create what you want in your life. But people keep on raising the bar of survival so much that they will not get to do anything in their life except surviving. In the end, they don't know why they survived.